Hello everyone, we Dr. Della Mugavala and Dr. Kashmira Mugavala welcome you all to this introductory lecture on cervical spine, that is the neck region. Firstly, we would like to thank all of you all who joined us for the spinal workshop, the low back and the upper back pain. We had an overwhelming response of members joining in and an excellent workshop with great feedbacks. Our next workshop is on cervical spine, that is the neck region, and this is a short introductory lecture about how and why you get neck pain and what are the various other problems that are associated with cervical region problems. So please go through this section. So the cervical spine, the neck region, is called as the cervical spine, and the cervical spine, the spine has small bones, that is vertebral bodies, which make up the spine. Each vertebral body, there are 7 vertebral bodies in the cervical region which form a curve which is facing backwards, and it is called as cervical lordosis. So there are 7 small pieces of these cervical bones which form the cervical lordosis. And this region is the region of your neck. So in this much region, you have around 7 small pieces of bones. Now, if you see the current situation, everything is getting digitalized. Okay, most of the time, most of the people are spending time on their computers, laptops or mobiles. Now, when you are spending time on your computer or laptop, generally when you are sitting across a computer, you tend to look at the screen like this, right? No matter how well you have equipped yourself with a proper chair, an ergonomic chair, etc. But still, when you are looking at the screen, whether it be a mobile, a tablet or a laptop, you tend to look forwards like this. And this is called as forward head posture. Slowly, when you are constantly into this posture, this gives a very poor posture to our neck region, and a prolonged poor posture gives rise to a lot of problems. Also, the other thing which is associated with our neck region is the movement of the head. We move our head so many times in the day. When you want to look here, look there, look up, down, any particular activity is associated with some movement in the cervical spine. And hence, there is excessive movement in the cervical spine, in the neck region, as compared to other body parts. And hence, excessive movement and a prolonged poor posture, both of them give rise to tightness of the muscles in the neck region. Now, these tight muscles will restrict the normal mobility of your neck, and the restricted mobility will in turn, and when you like move your head on a neck which is stiff, that gives rise to wear and tear of these vertebral bodies. So they start rubbing against each other and undergo degenerative changes. These are called as cervical spondylitis. So many a times your x-rays might be reading that you have early degenerative changes or changes of cervical spondylitis. So what is that? That is basically a wear and tear of these cervical joints because of poor posture and excessive movement, and that causes this condition called as cervical spondylitis, which is extremely common, giving rise to pain in the neck region. Trapeziitis, that is this muscle which is here at the nape of the neck, that tends to get tight because of the problems which are associated with the neck. So these muscles tend to get tight. Not only that, these muscles, which the trapezius muscles, which forms the nape of your neck, these muscles also tend to get tight when you undergo any stressful situation, fear, stress, anxiety. So our first reaction to fear or stress is what we tend to contract like this, and these muscles tend to go tight, and they are also very closely associated with the neck and hence give rise to neck pain. There is also a very common condition which is called as cervicogenic headaches. That is, people get severe headaches, and these headaches are associated with neck issues. So spondylitic changes in the cervical spine give rise to pain in the head, because the nerve supply from your also supplies to the head region, and you get severe cervicogenic headaches which can progress to vertigos. So they are called as cervicogenic vertigos. These also occur because of these spondylitic changes which happen in the cervical region. Yet another common condition which happens in the cervical region is cervical slip disc. Like, as you have lumbar slip disc in the back, lower back, similarly you can have a slip disc in the cervical region. So there are many patients who have complaints of tingling sensation in the arms, in the hands. That is because the nerve is getting compressed in the neck. This could be because of a disc pressing on the nerve, or because of the degenerative changes, the bony prominences of the degenerative changes which are pressing on the nerve, and that gives tingling sensation in the hands. So there are a whole lot of problems associated with neck, and mainly the root cause, if you trace back, goes to poor posture and excessive neck movements and wrong neck movements. So in this workshop we are going to deal with neck pain. We will be dealing with certain exercises which will help you in reducing the neck pain, relaxing the nape of the neck, that is trapezius muscle. We will be dealing with cervicogenic headaches. We will be dealing with cervical spondylitis, as to what exercises, mobility as well as strengthening need to be done for the cervical spine. And we will be dealing with cervicogenic vertigo, and also the nerve compressions of the upper limb which are caused due to cervical problems. So this is what we are going to deal in this 6 days workshop. It will be a 5 days WhatsApp workshop where we will be sending text material in the form of explanations, audios and videos of exercises, so that people can understand what exercises need to be done in each condition. And on the final day, we will be having a live session where we will be discussing about how to understand the neck problems, and we will be doing supervised exercises in the live session. So do join us for this workshop as well. Thank you.